To open the way for these gatherings today, we're honoring the generations of women that came before us through spoken word and prayer. I'm joined by Sophia Bendelli, Marilyn Worrell, and Dr. Akilah Wright. Before we move to honoring the generations that came before, they are going to intro some of what they will be sharing in future months.
My mother honoring her sisters and her sisters-in-law and her sister friends. So I had a sense of what it means to honor women from my childhood. And understanding the expanded definition of mother is to create as well as procreate. But I really want to talk about 1965 Selma to Montgomery March that I was
on. In order to do that, I had to be real clear on choices that I was going to make in my life with how I was going to be an artist, to be told. And from that, my activism began through my art, and I identify in one simple phrase, I don't do the minstrel show unless it's a tribute to Burt Williams. And I don't tap dance unless you understand the code. But I have many children who I care for, who are in my life,
of one of those first
independent avant-garde Black oriented cultural centers. At that time it was called Studio O, which later became...
I knew I was going to be a doctor, but God had a different calling for me, and I realized my truest calling was to be a teacher, and in time to be what I consider a child whisperer or a teacher whisperer, to whisper to the hearts of children and those who are taught by them. Wow, motherhood. Motherhood did not come easy for me. I had to pray. I always say that I went up to heaven. So my activism began when I was about 10 years old. And I had integrated many schools, or different schools I had integrated. And I moved up to the Bronx around that time.
Happy Mother's Day.